Hello everyone, I am Fazlia Hassan and I am presenting on prevalence of knee osteoarthritis and risk factors among females in a suburban setting in Sri Lanka. The other authors are Prasanalika Gunawardana, Dr. Inoshi Athukolla, Akalanka Hettiheva and Indra Lekhangiya. So when considering the prevalence of knee osteoarthritis, the reason we selected the prevalence of knee osteoarthritis is because it is known as a common cause of pain and disability, but the prevalence of knee osteoarthritis and its risk factors within Sri Lanka, very few studies have been done on the prevalence. So this study is looking at the prevalence of knee osteoarthritis in and its risk factors among the females in suburban Colombo. This is a community-based study conducted among a representative sample of about 657 females in the age group of over 50. The prevalence of symptomatic knee osteoarthritis was determined by the clinical criteria as set by the American College of Rheumatologists, or called the ACR clinical criteria. It was also confirmed, this clinical criteria was then confirmed with targeted physical examination. Following that, an interviewer-administered questionnaire assessed the sociographic and health-related and behavior-related risk factors associated with symptomatic knee osteoarthritis in this sample. The prevalence was found to be 20.1% in one or both knees, giving a study sample with the prevalence of symptomatic knee osteoarthritis is 132. From the behavioral factors which were analyzed, kneeling, squatting, standing, heavy lifting, and stair climbing for more than 15 minutes per day, these were considered significant risk factors. So when you look at the prevalence as shown, it's 20% as in both one or both knees, the prevalence is found to be 20%. As well as performing heavy physical activity, frequently being barefoot inside or outside the house for a duration of past 10 years, they were not considered significant risk factors. From the associated social demographic risk factors, a low education level was considered a significant risk factor. The other risk factors that were considered were use of contraceptives, body mass index, previous knee surgery, and knee injury were found as significant risk factors. Out of these, none of them were found as significant risk factors. The prevalence of, this study, we can conclude that the prevalence of symptomatic knee OA among females above 50 years in Pitakote MOH area. So our study, it was done in the Pitakote Ministry of Health area in a suburban area. This was, the prevalence was found to be very high. This study has also identified a considerable number of modifiable behavioral risk factors associated with symptomatic knee osteoarthritis in this sample. Thank you.